my channel. If you're new, all of my social media is linked down below, along with my other veterinary vlogs. If you're interested in checking any of that out. Okay guys, so we're gonna go ahead and jump in and get started. So for those of you that do not know, I am specializing in dentistry, and this guy came to me Monday morning, and look how terrible his gingivitis is. His teeth are infected. That is pus underneath his gums. So he came to get his dental cleaning, but all of his teeth were mobile and they couldn't be saved because there was too much bone loss around these teeth. So these are the x-rays. This x-ray in particular is something that was really stressing me out about this patient. So for those of you that have no idea what you're looking at right here, so these two lines are pointing to the lower jaw, which is called the mandible. So that big tooth that you see to the left is the bottom molar, and the one to the right is the bottom premolar. Just to show a good comparison, this is what a normal mandible should look like. There's no bone loss here. So now you can see that the bone is supposed to be from the bottom pink line up to the top pink line. Yes, no, yes, no, good, bad. Anyway, so this little bugger right here that the arrow is pointing to is a tooth root abscess. The reason why this stresses me out is because the arrow with the circle is the only thing that is holding this dog's jaw together. It is about to fracture that little circle, which is probably a couple centimeters in length. He could literally fracture his jaw by chewing on his kibbles, by chewing on a bone, anything like that. This is what happens when periodontal disease goes untreated. Other than his jaw about to fracture, the rest of these x-rays are just as bad. I can't even imagine how much pain this little guy was in. So needless to say, all of this guy's teeth were pulled. He only ended up having two teeth left in his mouth that were actually viable. This is gonna look like I just fractured the tooth in half, but I didn't. That giant chunk I just cracked off was a chunk of tartar. That was the only thing holding this dog's tooth in its mouth. So once I got all of the infection cleaned out of his mouth and we got rid of all the non-viable teeth, I just went through and flushed everything with some Chlorhex rinse. I also applied a synthetic bone graft to where all of the teeth were that were pulled, just to help regrow the jaw. And then I went through and sutured everything closed. I did recommend to his owner to come back in a couple months so we can re-radiograph his jaw, and hopefully his bone has started to regrow. I got a fast pass to the front of the line, and I'm rolling now with some friends of mine. I got the modest touch wherever I go. It's gold, it's gold. Yeah, wherever I go, I'll let it out tonight. Pour another shot of whatever you like. Can't feel better than this. If I play the lottery, I probably win. I'm on a roll. I'm hitting every green light. I'm on a roll. I couldn't lose a hand if I tried. I'm on a roll. My ex wants sex tonight. Life's good, you know I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna light it up like the 4th of July. If I can keep it up, I ain't sleeping at night. Cause up till now it's been a hell of a ride. I'll let it out tonight. Pour another shot. Okay guys, so this is actually pretty cool. Do you see this little tiny hole right there? That is actually a cuterebra larva. They are fly larvae, so it's a type of maggot. A cuterebra is the larva of a fly which is embedded into the skin of your pet. So the cuterebra, or the botfly, is almost an inch long parasite. The usual host for these larvae are rodents or rabbits. The larva finds a natural opening in the animal, such as the nose, mouth, eyes, or sometimes even a cut, and that's how it enters the body. From there, they migrate through the organs until they reach the skin. Once they reach the skin, they burrow and make a hole so they can breathe through. These types of larvae do have to be surgically removed. You do not want to remove them at home. If you do, you risk the larva breaking apart, and that can cause a severe infection or an allergic reaction in your pet. This is what the little guy looks like underneath the microscope. He was actually pretty tiny. It's probably one of the smallest cuterebral larvae I've ever seen, but we pulled this from a little baby kitten. You can see all the little spines all over his body, and that just helps him burrow his way out of the pet's body into the surface of the skin. All right, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!